First things first, this whole career field is called marine science, not marine biology. Marine biology is the science that deals with animals and plants that live in the sea. It also deals with airborne and terrestrial organisms that depend directly upon bodies of salt water for food and other necessities of life. Marine science, on the other hand, combines all types of scientific disciplines into the marine world, which can be more interesting, but also can be more complicated, since everything around us acts, behaves very differently in water, specifically salt water. Enough of this. Let me guide you through the steps on realizing your ambitions to be in marine science. I will describe all the educational life stages plus extra schooling. So, if you want to jump to that stage in the video, be my guest. I will put the times in the description below. But if you want to listen to the whole thing, then let's begin. We begin at elementary school, where dreams are formed for you guys here to get inspired. You need to get hands-on and see with your own eyes things that deal with marine science. Having a fish tank in the classroom and or going on field trips brings the wonders of the sea right into your minds. Field trips could be to an aquarium, research station facility, the beach, the ocean, boat rides, watching inspiring movies, etc. If the elementary school that you go to doesn't have a fish tank, or could go to marine-related field trips, then ask your parents to see if they could go with you as an activity or a trip. If even that's not possible, you can watch TV or online shows that teaches you the subjects in a fun way. Some TV or online shows include Octonauts, Captain Planet, Wildcats, SpongeBob SquarePants, Popping Rock, Splash and Bubbles, and Aquaman, just to name a few. If you get inspired here and now, then you can hopefully influence your parents to learn more about marine science. Transitioning to middle school. This is where you gain interest in learning by having your teachers spark curiosity and jumpstart your career path. This is where you get introduced to science as different sub-disciplines and getting to dive deeper in different concepts, but mostly biology and chemistry, since those two are the most visible and eye-catching to us. Could be hard to mix in marine science concepts here because the traditional curriculum focuses on land or terrestrial systems, and the differences are very opposite that you might be confused before studying for their exams. The teachers here can introduce a little bit or have the year broken up into half terrestrial and half marine. You will most likely will not remember the details in middle school, but you could remember things here if it's interesting and or shocking. So the engagement methods right now are STEM or STEAM. After this point in your education, there is commonly a split in the town's cities program. Either you keep going to your public school, doing what most kids do, and get a generalized education where you increase your knowledge at all subject classes. Or you could go to a private school where you can accelerate your college career by taking more classes that interest you and would go into more detail than your public school counterpart. The scenario would be that you have to pay out of pocket for the private school, and you would have to build your own resume from the start of middle school. Simply put, it's like college admissions for middle school students. The types of science classes in this stage besides biology and chemistry are physics and environmental science. Physics is because now you know algebra, geometry, and trigonometry. Environmental science is because you know the concepts in biology and chemistry. The issue that I think teachers should teach more of is geology, because there's a lot more things besides the rock cycle, volcanoes, or even earthquakes that are as or even more important in daily life. If you are really serious about marine science at this point, you need to really plan out your future career path, because there's a lot of options. What I'm talking about are summer programs, internships, or volunteer opportunities. Depending on where you live in the US, it could be either easier or harder to get the experiences that you want. Look out for high school scholarships that organizations hand out to dedicated students. Opportunities range from looking at general ecologies, fish genetics, to working on rehabilitating marine mammals. These paid programs take at least a year prior to plan for, so you should look at the programs at the same time too. Another thing to look at are job postings that you would want to do in the future on websites like Indeed, Monster, and LinkedIn, to see what skills or qualifications that they are looking for, and then plan a timeline on when you will accomplish those things. This is a key tip that I wished I knew before going to college. Two important practical skills that you can do right now are communication skills and writing skills. A person that inspired me at this stage was Felipe Gusto Jr., the grandson of the famous marine biologist Jacques Gusto. After this, you come to the stage that most people have a hard time with, and ironically, most professionals wish to return to college. In the college stage, I'm going to break it up into three parts: associate, bachelor's or undergraduate, master's or graduate, and thirdly, doctorates or PhD and postdoc. The point of going to college is that even though you may have a lot of experiences and job skills, you still need advanced knowledge to move up to more technical or highly sought after roles. not only to know things more broadly, horizontally, but more in-depth, vertically, into individual topics. To begin, keep in mind as you go to college that different schools have different funding income opportunities. If I recall correctly, there's these kinds to choose from. On-campus jobs, such as in dorms, apartments, food or retail, TAs or GAs, for masters and above, and research assistants, depending on grants. Colleges will have more scholarships that cater to being a minority, being a woman, startup programs, in-demand majors such as STEM, and student life organizations clubs. I suggest before you do any degree, undergraduate or graduate, and choosing a college to do it in, make sure you look up their professor's bios to see if you are interested in their work and if you want to work with them on a research project in the near future. For courses, there are four different types. The first is the common one that runs every semester. The second is the alternate one that runs every other semester. This would usually be your math, chemistry, and physics courses, having the Roman numeral 1 at the fall while Roman numeral 2 at the spring. The third one is the multi-year or cyclic, because these run on a cycle due to a professor's practice. The fourth and last one are specialty courses that is taught by a department chair or a regular professor who has special knowledge in a unique field. These specialty courses are mostly unknown to any student or perhaps even other faculty beforehand, and you would only know if you ask the person. Or flyers would be posted all around the department buildings from a year before it happens to just the semester before. In this first part of an undergraduate degree, I suggest that you major in a general science like biology, chemistry, physics, environmental science, geology, etc. This way, it will give you a chance to know more general knowledge that you can decide which specific discipline to focus on in your later education. It's also beneficial to you if you choose to work in this time or right after, because your credentials will be more flexible, making you more employable. My advice here would be to not do those so-called combined programs with a master's degree. Sure, the professors might throw you in with one more year of schooling, no need to take the GREs, and a guaranteed acceptance, since they would most likely be the same person they would contact anyway. Don't fall for it, because at the end of the day, even though you have more academic knowledge with your newly achieved master's degree, you don't have any lengthy period of professional work in the sciences. Resume tip. Under experiences, employers want to know what you have completed or done for the company, not just the position's role. If you can show files or printouts of completed work as examples can put down any numerical values if you can. The two people who influenced me at this point was Rachel Carson and Sylvia Earle, who are marine activists. The next step in college would be a master's degree. While transitioning from your bachelor's to your master's, consider doing research in multiple labs, if you can. This way, it can diversify your niche before you finally graduate later on. And since you usually make posters for that to show at academic events, you can add them to your portfolio for future career interviews. Now, I know people say that, oh, getting a master's is better than just a bachelor's, since you would stand out above the crowd and you will get more pay right off the bat. While that can be true, it's also overinflated because the fact that people having a master's degree is more common now than it was in the 1900s. And I think the degree is tailored more towards academia, being a professor or research assistant, than getting any workforce job, non-profit, public, private, or government sector. But some colleges have degrees that will tailor more to people who want to go in the workforce. One type is called a MPS degree, or Master of Professional Studies. The other one is called a PSM, or Professional Science Master. In place of a traditional master's thesis, you will have a capstone course that places you in an internship in your desired field. If neither of that does it for you, may I suggest two highly blended fields, environmental economics and marine policy. But if you have no choice and are going to do a master's thesis, make sure to do one under a professor's grant, such as from the NSF or any other recognized scientific organizations. These grants usually need to have the recipient professor give a timetable and proof of what they did to publishing journal articles and get awarded larger amounts of money than the state local grants, meaning more to distribute to his or her student research assistants. We are coming towards higher college degrees that you can take, and those are a doctorate, PhD, and a postdoc, which is not a degree per se, as it is just extra research time. Now, I can't speak to this part because I don't have a PhD nor a postdoc, but I know some people on this platform who do. All that I know is that every PhD is vastly different, even similar ones, because of their unique curriculum and where does their income stream, basically funding, scholarships, etc., comes from. For the most part, they all have the same rigorous work, stress, management, and delegation skills needed to complete one. As for my experience through my college years, I found that people that are in the marine sciences are the most fun and interesting to work with. If you want to learn what would you do after a PhD, or have marine career questions in general, please comment below and I will try to supply that information to you, either in an answer or in a video. As always, till next time.